Honeybee, I'm going to stay in bed today. I just don't have much energy.
Hello? Anyone home?
Oh, come in, Amira. What perfect timing.
Sorry to come by so early. I heard you were feeling poorly, Hazel.
How could you have heard that?
Well, I try to make a house call at least once a month. I'm sorry I haven't been by more recently. Here's some medicine for Hazel.
Thanks.
It will make her more comfortable. There's not much more we can do, I'm afraid.
What? You're just giving up?
That's not fair. I've tried referring her to the best specialists and research trials, but she refused them all. Anyway, I need to get back to the clinic. Hazel, get some rest.
I will. Don't worry. Tara's taking good care of me. Oh, don't be mad at Amira, honeybee. She's right. I decided to enjoy the time I had left, rather than be strapped to a bed with tubes coming out of me. I'm grateful that I've had the strength to teach you what I can. I am not afraid of what comes next.
This looks like a key to... I'm all out of strength. I could eat some food to recover some strength, or try again tomorrow.
Your grandma was one of the first folks who came to greet me when I moved here. She brought me some fresh veggies and some soup. It made me feel real welcome.
I'm glad you've come to take care of her.
Thank you.
Is it time for bed?
Honeybee, can we chat for a moment before you go out for the day?
Sure, Grandma.
I want you to know I've left you the farm in my will. I already spoke to Arthur about it, and he understands. Farm life was never for him. I don't want you to feel obliged if you'd rather return to your old life in the city. But tell me, do you want to stay on after I'm gone?
Grandma, you're not giving me the farm. You're going to get better.
Oh, honeybee. That's just not the case, I'm afraid. It's better to be prepared. I'm glad that's settled then. I'll have Otto finish the paperwork.
Morning! Brought you some groceries.
Oh, let me get you some money.
Oh, don't you dare. It's the least Parker and I could do.
Thank you, Lina, dear. You will look after Terra for me, won't you? I've done what I can to get her ready to take my place here, but she'll need a guiding hand.
I will. Well, I better let you rest.
Give my love to Marcus when you see him.
Thank you. I have the wheat you wanted.
Better get that meatless grinder going. Or, whatever you use to make Satan.
Oh, yes. Give me a day to make it, then drop by my store for some fresh Satan. And in the meantime, fair wages for fair work.
Damon's let me stay on his couch. His place is nice and all, but...
Thank you.
Should I go to bed? Is it time for bed?
Morning. Brought you some firewood, Hazel.
How kind of you, Thomas.
I'll just, go somewhere else.
Lina told me you've been a bit under the weather.
I have. But Terra's been doing a pretty good job taking care of the farm, wouldn't you say?
I suppose. Hazel, I just wanted to say thank you. After my dad passed, you and Robert were there for us. I have never forgotten it.
It was the least we could do. Most things I picked up watching your dad in his garden.
He was right about most things when it came to farming. Hard as it was for me to admit. He was just so stern and impossible to please. Well, I'll be on my way.
Tell me this is about the paper. Are you giving it to me instead of Cameron?
Guess who's the lucky winner of the passive-aggressive paper wars?
Oh, thank you, Tara. Look, I know this whole thing might seem petty.
I mean, a little.
I just don't want people to get in over their heads, you know? Here's something for your trouble.
Is it time for bed?